To the Supreme Lord, whose form is the embodiment of eternal existence, knowledge, and bliss. Whose shark-shaped earrings are swinging to and fro. Who is beautifully shining in the divine realm of Gokul. Who, due to the offense of breaking the pot of yogurt, that his mother was churning into butter, and then stealing the butter that was kept hanging from a swing, from the wooden grinding mortar in fear of Mother Yashoda. But who has been caught from behind by her, who ran after him with greater speed to that Supreme Lord. To that Supreme Lord Damodar, I offer my humble obeisances. I offer my respects. That ends the first verse. So go to the second verse now. Seeing the whipping stick in his mother's hand, he is crying and rubbing his eyes again and again. And his two lotus hands. Sorry, with his two lotus hands. His eyes are filled with fear, and the necklace of pearls around his neck which is marked with three lines like a conch shell is shaking because of his quick breathing due to crying. To this Supreme Lord, Sri Damodar, whose belly is bound not with ropes, but with his mother's pure love, I offer my humble obeisances. So we are moving to third verse now. Second is over. By such childhood pastimes as this, he is drowning the inhabitants of Gokul in pools of ecstasy. And is revealing to those devotees who are absorbed in knowledge of his supreme majesty and opulence that he is conquered only by devotees with pure love. With great love, I again offer my obeisances to Lord Damodar hundreds and hundreds of times. So moving to fourth verse. O Lord, although you are able to give all kinds of benedictions, I do not pray to you for the boon of impersonal liberation. Nor the highest liberation of eternal life in Vaikuntha. Nor any other boon. Which may be obtained by executing 9 processes of bhakti. O Lord, I simply wish that this form of yours, as Bal Gopal in Vrindavan, may ever manifest in my heart. For what is the use to me of any other boon besides this? Fifth verse. O Lord, your lotus face, which is encircled by locks of soft black hair, tinged with red, is kissed again and again by Mother Yashoda. And your lips are reddish like the bimba fruit. May this beautiful vision of your lotus face be ever manifest in my heart. Thousands and thousands of other benedictions are of no use to me. Sixth verse. O Supreme Godhead, I offer my obeisances unto you. O Damodar, O Anant, O Vishnu, O Master, O my Lord, be pleased upon me. By showering your glance of mercy upon me, deliver this poor ignorant fool who is immersed in an ocean of worldly sorrows and become visible to my eyes. 7th verse. O Lord Damodar, just as the two sons of Kuber, Managreev and Nalukuvar, were delivered from the curse of Narad, and made into great devotees by you in your form as a baby, tied with a rope to a wooden grinding mortar. In the same way, please give to me your own prema bhakti. I only long for this and have no desire for any kind of liberation. Eighth and final words. O Lord Damodar, I first of all offer my obeisances to the brilliantly effulgent rope which binds your belly. I then offer my obeisances to your belly, which is the abode of the entire universe. I humbly bow down to your most beloved Srimati Radha Rani. And I offer all obeisances to you the Supreme Lord who displays unlimited pastimes. यशोदा दामोदर की जय, राधा दामोदर की जय। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।